What is it?
देवी और सज्जनों, संस्थान का के 28वें स्थापना दिवस का शुभारंभ कुछ ही देर में किया जाएगा। आप सभी से अनुरोध है कि अपने अपने स्थान ग्रहण कर लें और अपने मोबाइल्स साइलेंट मोड में रखें। धन्यवाद। नमस्कार लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। संस्थान के 28वें स्थापना दिवस के अवसर पर आप सबको हमारी हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू द 28th फाउंडेशन डे सेलिब्रेशंस ऑफ आईआईटी गुवाहाटी। देवियों और सज्जनों, ये हमारा सौभाग्य है कि आज हमारे बीच मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में उपस्थित हैं असम के माननीय मुख्यमंत्री डॉक्टर हिमंत बिस्व शर्मा। हमारे बीच विशिष्ट अतिथि के रूप में उपस्थित हैं आईआईटी गुवाहाटी के पूर्व निदेशक प्रोफेसर गौतम बरुआ। वी वेलकम आर एस्टीम्ड डिग्निटरीज टू द सेलिब्रेशंस। तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, भारतीय संस्कृति की एक सुंदर परंपरा है कि किसी भी शुभ कार्य का शुभारंभ हम भगवान का नाम लेकर और पवित्र दीप प्रज्वलन से करते हैं। हम निवेदन करना चाहेंगे मुख्य अतिथि महोदय असम के माननीय मुख्यमंत्री डॉक्टर हिमंत बिस्व शर्मा से, विशिष्ट अतिथि प्रोफेसर गौतम बरुआ से तथा आईआईटी गुवाहाटी के निदेशक प्रोफेसर टी जी सीताराम से कि कृपया पवित्र दीप प्रज्वलन कर कार्यक्रम का शुभारंभ करने की कृपा करें। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, the lighting of the auspicious lamp by our esteemed dignitaries and the Ganesh Vandana playing in the background marking an auspicious beginning of the program.
कवीनामुपवश्रवस्तम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पद आन शृण्वन्वोदिभिः सीतसाधनम् ॐ श्री महागणपतये नमः।
धन्यवाद महोदय। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल टू प्लीज राइज फॉर द इंस्टीट्यूट एंथम। देवियों और सज्जनों, एक और सुंदर भारतीय परंपरा है, अतिथि देवो भव। वी वुड लाइक टू फॉर्मली वेलकम आवर एस्टीम्ड डिग्निटरीज। बिफोर वी बिगिन विद द फेलिसिटेशन, मे आई रिक्वेस्ट द डेप्यूटी डायरेक्टर ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट प्रोफेसर एस के काकोटी, द रजिस्ट्रार ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट प्रोफेसर ए श्रीनिवासन एंड द डीन ऑफ एकेडमिक अफेयर्स प्रोफेसर चित्रलेखा महंतो टू प्लीज कम अप ऑन स्टेज and join the director of the institute in felicitating our honorable chief guest and the guest of honor. First of all, may I request the director of the institute to please felicitate our esteemed guests with the traditional Ohomya Eri Sador. Ladies and gentlemen, our esteemed guests, the chief guest is being felicitated with the horai. May I now request the registrar of the institute to please welcome our esteemed guests by presenting a memento which bears the logo of IIT Guwahati. May I now request the Dean of Academic Affairs, Professor Chitralekha Mohanto, to felicitate our Honorable Chief Guest and Guest of Honor with a copy of our very own coffee table book, The Birds of IIT Guwahati. May I request the Deputy Director of the Institute to please felicitate the guest of honor with the Eri Sador and the Horai. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. May I now request the Director of IIT Guwahati, Professor T.G. Sitaram, to please deliver the welcome address and also a report on the IITG activities.
Namaste. I extend a warm welcome to the 28th Foundation Day of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. Sir, IITG completed its 27th year on this day, since its start in September 1994. Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Hemanta Biswa Sharma ji, today's chief guest, Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, IIT Guwahati, Dr. Rajiv I. Modi, who is the Chairman and Managing Director of Cadila Pharmaceutical Limited. He is online. And Dr. Gautam Barua, Director of IIIT Guwahati and former Director of IIT Guwahati, today's guest of honor. Members of the Board of Governors, faculty members, officers and staff of the Institute, invited dignitaries, guests, students, members of the media, brothers and sisters. It's my pleasure to welcome all of you to this 28th Foundation Day of IIT Guwahati. I take this opportunity to express our solemn gratitude to Honorable Chief Guest of this 28th Foundation Day of IIT Guwahati, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Hemanta Biswa Sharma ji, for kindly agreeing to be the chief guest on this important day for IIT Guwahati. And also to our guest of honor, Dr. Gautam Barua, Director of IIIT Guwahati and former Director of IITG, for accepting the guest of honor and deliver the address today. I also thank Dr. Rajiv I. Modi, who is going to be with us online from United States of America. He is our chairman of Board of Governors, and his constant support to achieve the excellence of the Institute is always there. On behalf of IIT Guwahati, I wish to thank the Ministry of Education for their continued support to enhance the academic and research programs and infrastructure of the Institute, and the faith reposed on us. My personal thanks to the Honorable Minister of Education, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan ji, and three other state ministers, Rajkumar Ranjan Singh ji, Srimati Annapurna Devi, and Dr. Subhash Sarkar ji, and also our Secretary, Amit Khare ji, and other officers of the Ministry of Education on this day, very important day for IITG, which completing 27 year and entering into 28th year. Ministry was always gave excellent support to us for this growth of this Institute since its inception 1994, which has enabled us to achieve a number of milestones and has allowed us to set a new target for the future. Similarly, Government of Assam was always there for us and interacting with all our faculty and staff of the Institute on many occasions. I thank both the State Government of Assam and also Government of India on this day, and I also welcome all of you for this Foundation Day of IIT Guwahati. Dear colleagues, and all the people who are present in this auditorium, and also those who are watching this program on YouTube and Facebook through the social media platforms. Very pleased to inform you that IIT Guwahati is trying to leap forward by embracing rising demands of the newer and transdisciplinary areas of research and technology development by incorporating National Education Policy 2020 policies, including industry interaction and participation in offering courses in futuristic areas, providing thrust to startup culture, entrepreneurship at all levels, and creation of jobs, particularly in the Northeast. Through hard work of our faculty, staff, and student, IIT Guwahati has been ranked in 2022 second in India and 41st globally in citation per faculty category, and 395th rank globally in QS World Ranking 2022, jumping 75 positions in 2021. In all other ranking agencies also, like the Times Higher Education, the Impact Ranking of Global Ranking of 2021, IITG has been ranked in the top 200 universities for Sustainable Development Goal 4, that is Quality Education, Sustainable Development Goal 7, Affordable and Clean Energy, Sustainable Development Goal 9, Industry, Innovation and Infrastructure, and also in many other, you know, clean water and sanitation, reduced inequalities in all the other areas as well. IITG has improved overall world ranking to 350 in the Nature Index ranking and ranked within the top 10 in India overall, as well as four subject categories. Sir, in 2021, in QS international subject-wise ranking, IITG is fifth among of the IITs in the top 100 universities in the world. Even in our national NIRF ranking, IIT Guwahati has been ranked seventh, which is in the National Institutional Ranking Framework conducted by MHRD in the year 2020. IIT Guwahati is one of the most beautiful educational campuses in the country that provides an ideal setting for learning and research. And we believe that we are learning in tandem with the tides of the mighty Brahmaputra at the vibrant campus of IIT Guwahati. Sir, it is strongly believed that IIT Guwahati has been able to fulfill the aspiration of the people of the Northeast region to a large extent, and in particular, the state of Assam. Since its inception was through the Assam Accord, signed in 1985. The institute is fully residential for the students, enriched with world-class facilities, and is empowered with a young and dynamic faculty and staff. IIT Guwahati has been conducting all teaching and evaluation in online mode only during the pandemic, and completing the academic commitments on time. And we are the first one to actually complete the convocation of 2021 as well on time. Sir, we are also thinking, in line with the Assam state government order, thinking of opening our campus to all the students now. However, I would like to mention you, sir, there are 2,000 students are already in the campus who are our research scholars, who are doing research and development even during this pandemic. An important feature of academic excellence of any institute is the continuous replenishment of ideas and creation of new areas of research and innovation, attracting organizations seeking collaboration in education, research and development, as well as product development. During the reporting year, we have created four new schools: Mehta Family Foundation School of Data Sciences and Artificial Intelligence, which is completely supported philanthropically by Mehta Family Foundation from Houston, Texas, through their philanthropic support. We have also started, sir, School of Health Sciences and Technology, and we had School of Rural, Agro and Rural Technologies, and School of Energy Sciences and Engineering, even during this pandemic year. We also thank you on this occasion. You had inaugurated our new center on disaster management and research a couple of months back. And we have also started two other centers in this pandemic year, Center for Intelligent Cyber Physical Systems, which offers master's and PhD programs, which is completely supported by DST's Technology Incubation Hub. And then Center for Indian Knowledge System with a PhD program. We are waiting for our Honorable Minister of Education to come and inaugurate that. And we again, we request you also to be with him on that day to do the honor. In the years to come, IIT Guwahati, with transdisciplinary focus and specialized centers to attract talent, we would become the ultimate destination of scholars and scientists from the world over. We have established a new virtual center on the Australia-India Water Center, focusing on mission water. With 10 universities from Australia and 13 universities from India to focus on mission water, and centered at IIT Guwahati, which will be working very closely with Australia and Indian universities on River Brahmaputra, and particularly on very various related, and also meeting the demands of the Jal Mission to supply drinking water to every village and town in the Northeast. In 2019, we have started an industry interaction and special initiative cell to focus on industry interaction. This year, every department and center has industry advisors who are accomplished industrialists to interact with our faculty. They are going to advise the department regarding industry needs and modify the curriculum over a period of time for industry needs, so that our students are ready before even they take up their jobs there. We have also been able to further our links with international and national peer universities and institutes, and in particularly centrally funded technical institutes and universities in the northeast of India. Recently, with AICTE and IIT Guwahati, sir, we have created large reservoir of expertise and techniques, coordinated effort between IIT Guwahati and All India Council for Technical Education, New Delhi, to enhance the functional efficiency of the technical institute located in the far-flung areas of the northeastern region, which will improve the quality of education and capacity building at grassroots level and change the lives of the common people of the northeastern region. Sir, thanks to AICTE, which funded these institutions, more than 30 institutions selected, and we are expanding that to 60 institutions in the coming year, to provide alternate power support and water issues in the campus and internet connection. IIT Guwahati team is handling these institutions, and AICTE is funding them directly, and our team is actually helping them to in all aspects of identifying the problems and solutions, and also even calling for tender and making all these functional, so that solar power and water and internet connection is there throughout without any disturbing. This will go in a long way to enhance the functional efficiency of these technical institutes located in the far-flung areas of the northeastern region. Sir, our team also helped all the MITs in the new way of education, adopting to the new way of blended learning and flipped classes through some training programs online at IIT Guwahati. The institute has been able to attract outstanding faculty members, sir, from not only just from India, but other parts of the globe as well. Today, I'm happy to inform you that we have 410 faculty members on roll and 80 plus visiting faculty and honorary faculty from across the world, with many of them globally acknowledged for their research contributions. In this year, we have inducted more than 42 distinguished faculty and visiting professor and honorary professors from prestigious Indian and foreign universities. We have also inducted some industry professionals as professors of practice in different departments and centers. IIT Guwahati has signed many MOUs and memorandum of understanding established during this period with different universities and industries, both from India and abroad. These encompass inter-institutional collaboration to bring together the best resources in the national interest and moving from tower of excellence to a network of excellence. The progress of IIT Guwahati on all fronts have been extremely laudable in the past year, despite the unforeseen difficulties faced due to the current pandemic. I would like to acknowledge the devoted efforts of the faculty, staff, students, and administration of the institute towards achieving these goals. The vision of IIT Guwahati is to become a preferred destination at seeking best science, engineering, and technology education, and to be recognized internationally for excellence in research, pursuit for developmental activities, and deep concern for students' care. We have also laid an emphasis on knowledge creation through research and development activities of the institute. So we have several joint degree programs with both Indian universities and international universities. We have set up under the National Supercomputing Mission, IITG has set up two supercomputers. One is under installation, and I had informed you earlier, we named it as Paramkamru, which is 850 teraflop machine. Another one we are already having since last 5 years, which is Param Ishan, which is a 250 teraflop supercomputer supported by National Supercomputing Mission. At present, there are 72 MOUs active with institutions and organizations from all over the world. During this coronavirus pandemic, IIT Guwahati has signed and renewed MOUs with 15 international universities and institutions and organizations. And even during this pandemic, a significant number of full-time students from different countries such as Bhutan, Tanzania, Bangladesh, Nepal, Germany, and France have registered at different programs at IITG. We are also several semester exchange and research internships with partner universities have also happened with countries like Japan, France, and many other countries. IITG attracts the brightest student from different countries as well for their and also from entire India for bachelor's, master's, and doctoral program. In the 27 years of existence, more than 16,000 students have graduated from IIT Guwahati. So our alumni is growing, and some of them have done excellently well and bringing fame to the country. The alumni of the institute have made their alma mater proud through their achievements and contribution in diverse fields. So we have also instituted several awards to recognize their contribution to the nation. IITG has done very well in terms of research publication during the current year. In fact, we are next to Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, for the number of research publications in the Scopus Index in 2020, which is close to 1,965. At present, 279 research projects are in progress with a total sanction value of close to 300 crores. These are completely generated by our faculty and research scholars. During the reporting year, close to about 70 crore was sanctioned for 79 new projects from different funding agencies. So we are also extensively involved, our faculty, in doing consulting activities for the state of Assam, and large number of projects actually handled by our faculty to the government of Assam, which generated close to about 13 crores as a revenue to IITG. Some of the industrial collaborative research are with Tata Steel, ONGC, Oil India Limited, and Samsung India Electronics, and Agricultural Rural Development Bank, National Rural Infrastructure Development Agency, and Numaligarh Refinery Limited, to name some of them, sir. The patents and publication, technology transfer, encouraging entrepreneurship would be valued most while taking stock of the human inventory at the Institute. Institute has taken bold steps to help faculty to do technology transfers and file more patents. Our technology innovation hub is the vertical of technology for underwater exploration, is recognized by DST, and we have more than 70 faculty members across India and also world working only on underwater technologies, which will be very, very useful because we are sitting next to Brahmaputra and see some of those. Sir, Innovation Center is functioning excellently well, and our Technology Incubation Center and Research Park has attracted large number of industries and startups in the campus. The development of infrastructure to meet the fast expanding academic activities, along with accommodation facilities for the students, faculty and staff, has been phenomenal during this year. We have actually more than 100 crore of the HEFA loan has been taken to augment this facility this year, and it's been completely approved. So we will have soon a new building for biosciences, bioengineering, and new undergraduate labs for training teachers in the Assam state as well as in the Northeast, particularly in the areas of physics, chemistry, and electrical engineering has been programmed. IIT Guwahati endeavors to make a mark as the Institute of International Standing and make this vision a reality, for which a committee was formed for advancing international standing of the Institute in August 2020. This committee, sir, has submitted a report called Art of an Institution. Art represents A for administration, R for research, T for teaching. Today, we'll be honored if you can release that book at the end of this program. With this brief introduction and progress of the Institute, I would like to highlight to you, our team also has worked on implementation of National Education Policy 2020, and we have already done many activities, and we have also brought out a document of the National Education Policy 2020 implementation plan at IIT Guwahati, which has also been approved by our Board of Governors. On the 75th Independence Day of IITG, we have taken a campaign to make IITG a gender-inclusive technology institute. So we have taken a pledge as Just Prayas under the umbrella of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, which has announced the launch a campaign called Just Prayas. Just in Hindi word means a glory, and Prayas is an attempt we are making. So we are trying to make a gender inclusive technology institute. We will add to this glory. We call it as Prayas, which means an attempt, because we know that there are larger social barriers which will take time to change, but every little effort we make today will help us to push for this change and make IITs a safe and nurturing space for girls. Aligning with this vision and mission, IIT Guwahati would always remain committed to student growth, social upliftment, and generate knowledge and resources for the benefit of future generations, while instilling sense of pride and belongingness, while fulfilling the aspirations of all stakeholders, including the state of Assam. Sir, thank you very much for accepting our invite to be here with us. And I also thank Dr. Gautam Barua, who has led this institute for 10 years, also with us. We are very, very happy to have you both, sir, here. On this foundation, 28th Foundation Day, IITG commits itself to work hard and to create new opportunities for the Northeast people, and in particular state of Assam, sir. This institute will become a network of excellence, connecting institutions across state of Assam and the Northeast. Thank you for your attention. I welcome all of you for this Foundation Day celebration. Jai Hind, Dhanyawad.
Thank you, sir. May I now invite on stage the Deputy Director of IIT Guwahati, Professor S. K. Kakuti, to present an introduction of Dr. Rajiv I. Modi, Chairman, Board of Governors, IIT Guwahati.
Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Chief Guest of today's function, Professor Gautam Barua, former director at Guwahati and guest of honor for today's function. Professor T.G. Sitaram, director at Guwahati. I am really delighted to place before you a brief introduction of Dr. R.I. Modi, the chairman of Board of Governors at Guwahati. Dr. Rajiv I. Modi is the chairman and managing director of Cadila Pharmaceuticals Limited, one of India's largest privately held pharmaceutical companies founded by his father, Sri Indrabadun A. Modi, in 1951. Upon assuming the company's leadership in 2012, Dr. Modi started a multi-pronged approach for the corporate growth with a vision to revolutionize the life sciences of industry. He has played a pivotal role in establishing research, manufacturing, sales and distribution for Cadila Pharma across the globe. Today, Cadila has a strong global presence with operations in the USA, Japan, CIS and Africa, and overseas formulations manufacturing unit at Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. Being a biotechnologist himself, Dr. Modi has played a significant role in developing Cadila's biotechnology division into a strong research and development unit focusing on new developments and breakthrough innovations. Dr. Rajiv Modi's passion to excel in the field of biosciences is reflected in his illustrious educational qualifications, PhD in biological sciences from the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor, USA, MSc in biochemical engineering from University College London, UK, and BTech in chemical engineering from Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Mumbai, India. So with this, thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a video message of our chairman, Board of Governors, will be played now.
I have the great pleasure of welcoming the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarmaji, and the past director of IIT Guwahati, Professor Gautam Baruaji, to the 20th Foundation Day of our prestigious IIT at Guwahati in the state of Assam. I want to welcome all students, alumni, our director, deputy director, deans, registrar, faculty and staff of IIT Guwahati community, and all stakeholders who are viewing this event both online and offline. Indian Institute of Technology at Guwahati was established in the year 1994 and has completed 27 years of glorious existence. As the chairman of the Board of Governors of the IIT Guwahati, I have the privilege to be part of an exciting journey. I have trained myself to take my responsibility seriously, and the responsibility as chairman of the Board of Governors of IIT Guwahati, I consider it my duty to help navigate the challenges to build IIT Guwahati as an institute of excellence in Northeast India, in India and in the world. It is our responsibility to oversee that we develop citizens fit for the future. It is our responsibility to oversee that the graduates of IIT Guwahati will help build the new India. Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarmaji, with your vast experience in health and education in the state and at national level, sir, you appreciate the importance of good quality education. And sir, I know that you are a firm believer that good education is the best equalizer of our people. Good education is a key facilitator is a key facilitator to realize the dream of our leader, our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Bhai Modi. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas. And also that our world-class education is a key pillar in the development of our country. And so at IIT Guwahati, we are continuously working together with our faculty to continuously improve the quality of education at IIT Guwahati. We are working together with our faculty to continuously improve quality of curriculum, making it relevant for the future, encourage high quality research and at the same time improve research outcomes, increase inflow of resources in terms of research grants, and energize our talented faculty to increase collaborations within the institute, among themselves, and more so increase the collaborations with other academicians and academic institutions within India and around the world. At IIT Guwahati, we strive to provide world-class education so that charged with education from IIT Guwahati, our graduates can get high-class jobs. And with IIT Guwahati degree, our graduates can participate in the development of our great country. Sir, in this ever-changing global dynamic, I urge you, Honorable Chief Minister, to increase collaboration between the state of Assam and the Indian Institute of Technology at Guwahati. After all, it's a premium institute in your state. Sir, I urge you to be the pioneer for greater collaboration of our faculty at IIT Guwahati and the state administration of the state of Assam. Please use the talented faculty as your think tank to help you and your administration in the development and growth of the state of Assam based on science and technology to build a better Assam, an Assam of the future, a new Assam. Sir, a better Assam will catalyze better Northeast India. Sir, I really look forward to your leadership in this regard. I also want to thank Professor Barua, Gaurav Gautam Barua ji, to be our special guest today. Sir, I am pleased that you are here to witness the rejuvenated IIT Guwahati, the institute that you so lovingly nurtured during your tenure here. Thank you for joining this important event, Professor Gautam Barua ji, and a big thank you to everyone present physically as well as online. I express my thank you to you, the Honorable Chief Minister, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma ji, for sparing your valuable time to be part of this important event. Let us all join hands and continue to work for the betterment of the state of Assam, the IIT Guwahati, and our beloved India. So, on this momentous occasion of the 28th Foundation Day of the Institute, I once again congratulate everyone for the development and growth of the Institute. With our collective efforts, we can do even better for the society and our country. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. May I now invite on stage the Dean of Academic Affairs, Professor Chitralekha Mohanto, to please present an introduction of our guest of honor, Professor Gautam Barua.
The chief guest of the function to the respected Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma. Guest of honor, Professor Gautam Barua, and Director of IIT Guwahati, Professor T.G. Sitaram, ladies and gentlemen. We are fortunate to have in our midst today Professor Gautam Barua, who was Director of IIT Guwahati and currently Director of Indian Institute of Information Technology, Guwahati. Professor Barua has his early education in the Sindhya School, Gwalior. He was the school captain in 1970 and received the President's Gold Medal for his commendable performance in the school. Professor Borwa obtained his B.Tech and M.Tech degrees from IIT Bombay in 1976 and 1978 in electrical engineering. He did his PhD in 1981 in computer science from the University of California, Santa Barbara. Following a brief stint as a visiting lecturer at UCSB, Professor Borwa returned home and joined IIT Kanpur as a faculty. Professor Borwa was a faculty member at IIT Kanpur in Computer Science and Engineering Department from 1981 to 1995. In 1995, he joined IIT Guwahati as a professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering and worked till 2016. Professor Borwa was involved in the establishment of IIT Guwahati since 1995 and took the institute to newer heights during his tenure as the director of the institute from March 2003 to August 2013 for consecutive 2 terms. In 2008, he was appointed the mentor director of IIT Patna. Since 2014, he has been involved in establishing IIIT Guwahati. He is serving as the mentor director of IIIT Guwahati from June 2016. He was awarded the Distinguished Alumnus Award by IIT Bombay in the year 2015. He works in the areas of operating systems and networks. He is a member of Computer Society of India, IEEE, ACM, and Institution of Engineers. He also has been an IT consultant to several government organizations and PSUs. As an academician, he has been actively involved in the leadership roles in institution building across the northeastern India. I welcome you, sir, and invite you as the guest of honor today to deliver your address on this 28th Foundation Day of IIT Guwahati. Thank you.
Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Director of IIT Guwahati, Professor Sitaram, Chairman Board of Governors, IIT Guwahati, Dr. Modi, my fellow professors, faculty of the Institute, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed great pleasure for me to be present at this important function commemorating the 27 years completion of this institute in its foundation day. Having heard the directors speak about the achievements, I am really very proud, because as you know that I have been involved with this institute for so many years in the beginning, and I am really proud to see the strides that have been taken by the institute, especially in the last, say, 6-7 years, the progress has been really, really good. Of course, I would, while congratulating all of you for doing so well, I, as usual, would like to also say that, you know, we are not done. We have to keep doing better and better. As an institution, 27 years is still a young institution. We are competing with the likes of Harvard and Oxford, which are hundreds of years old. And it takes time for an institute to mature and to really reach its peak. However, at the same time, we have to be ever on guard that we keep going up and not plateau or start going down. Because it's very easy to go down. And once you start slipping, the fall can be very fast. So we have to be constantly on our guard to ensure that the achievements that we have made are built upon in the years to come. There are so many things we can do. I'll just, in this short address, I will just mention one or two issues. First of all, I'd like to talk about teaching. We know IITs are known for their quality of students and teaching, but we have to be very careful, because our emphasis in the country as a whole has been towards research. And this, of course, has a historical reason, because in the earlier days of this country's progress, research was lagging behind. It's only in the 90s and onwards that research has really picked up in Indian institutions. So today, a lot of emphasis is there on research, which is a good thing, and we are doing very well. IIT Guwahati particularly is doing so well in its publications, citations, makes me very proud. But we have to be careful about the teaching part, because there is a danger that we may go easy on the teaching. And the danger is very real, because we get very good students. And even if you don't do anything while teaching or don't do a very good job, students still do well. But then we want to not be wanting to depend on our students to learn. We must also teach them. And there are huge opportunities now which can make our teachings become different, better. And I think this pandemic is playing a role, because before this pandemic came, we used to only talk about online courses, and there were some NPTEL courses many of us gave lectures in, but the use of the online medium was relatively less. But the pandemic has forced us now to go fully online. Now, even after the pandemic subsides, I'm not saying it's going away, even after it subsides, I think we will never be going back to our old ways of teaching. There is going to be hybrid teaching for sure. Both students will come to class, but we will have to also complement it with online material, with online aids. And we must therefore prepare ourselves for that hybrid environment in the years to come, so that we can excel, we can improve the productivity of teaching with the new tools, with the new technology. The other technology that has come in, as you know, and I know, it is making a buzz all over, is AI and machine learning. It is not just an area in computer science, but it is an area just like computers, say 20, 30 years ago, became a tool for all activities, and today it's ubiquitous. In research, for example, without a computing facility, we can't do anything. Soon, we are going to come to a stage where no research is going to take place without using AI tools to make the research go forward. And so we must be ready for that. And I'm glad to see that a center of AI and data science has been established. And that is the way to go forward. And I think one of the things I would like to suggest is that, we need data. To learn, for the machine to learn, it needs data, it needs labeled data. We have to collect data. And I think IIT Guwahati is well placed to collect data of this region, because data also has to be specific to the area for which we are trying to find solutions. So whether it is health data or it is satellite data, which is so important in so many areas like floods and erosion and landslides, we must collect data, label them, and IIT Guwahati can become a repository for our data. Our researchers should not be going to Berkeley and Stanford data, and get their data sets and run them and write papers. People must use our data sets. We must have data of our own, which we will then make available to the community at large, and particularly to the community in this Northeast region, to do research using the new technologies that have been enabled by the advances in VLSI and computing, namely AI and machine learning. Finally, I just want to say one small thing about the new education policy. The director has already mentioned that the efforts that have been made by the institute, most of the points that are mentioned, or many of the points, let me put it, are already there in our IIT system, not only this IIT. But one of the things that is different is to make every university a multidisciplinary or full-fledged university. So already I have heard that, the School of Health Science, School of Energy, they are being established. Maybe I'd like to suggest that we should expand the humanities and social science area, we should start having BA programs, MA programs, maybe integrated MA programs in various humanities subjects. We could have a department of finance. Management is a tricky thing to have, but if we can, or maybe it can be part of finance. But we must work towards expanding our humanities base. Then only will our university institute become a truly full-fledged university. Even if you look, the name need not change. If you look at MIT, it's an MIT, Institute of Technology. But then the likes of Chomsky and others are there. So we have to strive for that kind of a situation in the years to come. And one more small point I want to make. Internationalization is one of the requirements of, or one of the goals of NEP. And you know, getting foreign students to come and join our institutes is not so easy. We must make a big thrust towards getting research scholars and master's students into our institutions. And I have already suggested in some other forum to the government that one of the ways that this can be made easier is to provide funding to foreign students. Students from our institute go to America and do PhD. How do they manage to do that? Because they get support from the research grants which NSF gives. But the research grants which DST gives us, we cannot hire foreign students or foreign citizens. So one of the most important thing I think is to get international research scholars to come in, is to press the government to allow the funding to be used for hiring foreign students. Then we can also offer research grants to students from all over the world and thereby enrich our PhD and research programs tremendously. I can go on and on. There are so many things we can do, we must do. I know you know better than me what all needs to be done. I would like to end by thanking the Institute for inviting me and being able to see and say a few words here. Thank you very much, and I wish all the best in the future.
Thank you so much, sir. May I now request the Registrar of the Institute, Professor A. Srinivasan, to please come up on stage and present an introduction of our Honorable Chief Guest.
Good morning. It gives me great pleasure in introducing our Chief Guest, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam. Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma was born on 1st February 1969 in Jorhat to Sri Kailashnath Sharma and Srimati Nalini Devi. He did his schooling mostly in Guwahati and passed his senior secondary examination from Kamrup Academy School in 1985. He completed his graduation and post-graduation in political science from Cotton College, Guwahati in the year 1990 and 1992 respectively. He obtained his law degree, that is LLB, from the Government Law College, Guwahati, and then his PhD from Guwahati University. Dr. Sharma was elected to the Assam Legislative Assembly from Jalukbari constituency for the first time in 2001. And then he was subsequently re-elected from the same constituency in 2006, 2011, 2016, and 2021. On 10th May 2021, he was sworn in as the 15th Chief Minister of Assam. In his illustrious career, he had held several posts, both at the state and the cabinet level, including the Minister of State for Agriculture, Planning and Development, Finance, Health and Family Welfare, Education, and Assam Accord implementation from 2002 to 2021. He is well known for his dynamism. We all know about him. We have seen how well he ramped up the health infrastructure and the testing facilities in the way to tackle the COVID pandemic. He revamped the teacher recruitment process also, and then he recruited about 50,000 teachers through the teacher eligibility test, which was a kind of a very novel thing that he did. In fact, the government of India, in its various annual reports, had singularly pointed out the achievements of the health and the education departments of Assam, which were under his tutelage. I think I don't want to embarrass him further. And with these few words of introduction, may I now request the Honorable Chief Minister to deliver his address.
Director of Indian Institute of Technology, Professor T.G. Sitharamji, former Director of IIT Guwahati and currently Director of IIIT Guwahati, Professor Gautam Borua, Deans, members of the faculty, staff, research scholars, students, dear media friends, and other distinguished guests present today in this hall and through online, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of people of Assam, I extend my greetings to all of you on the occasion of 28th Foundation Day of IIT Guwahati. I am really glad to be amongst you all on this occasion, and I wish to congratulate everybody associated with IIT Guwahati, whose untiring contribution have helped this institution to transform it into a center of excellence. This beautiful large green campus, located on the bank of the mighty Brahmaputra, has presented an ideal ambience for teaching, learning, and cutting-edge research and development activities. In a short span of close to three decades, IIT Guwahati has become known for its environment of academic and excellence in the entire globe with its quality education. This institute has produced globally competitive human resource and carried out research that significantly benefited the society at large. This shows the social commitment of this institute. I hope IIT Guwahati will grow to global prominence, and a graduate of this institute would lead the nation in every sphere of life. Celebration of Foundation Day is an important achievement for any organization. The 28th Foundation Day is also a milestone for IIT Guwahati, which has established itself a premier institute for teaching and research. I want to go back a little to a time frame between 1979 and 1985. During that time, we all witnessed a huge agitation in Assam, primarily for upliftment of our society, for basically protecting of the culture and heritage. In that agitation, many people, many of our brave boys and girls have laid down their lives. And when finally we signed that accord in 1985, apart from all other demands, political, social, what people of Assam has asked from Government of India, that give us a IIT. This institution has a history. IIT Bombay, IIT Kanpur, all these institutions has grown probably as a natural quest for excellence. We need to expand academics, we need to research, we need to do good for the country, we need a high level of academic institution. So all IITs has either been developed as a part of policy of the government of India or for the need of society. But IIT Guwahati has come into existence as a result of aspiration of the people of Assam. I have often come to being MLA or being the elected representative from this area. I used to come IIT Guwahati and I used to interact faculty members or the students of IIT. But I want that whenever we discuss about the history of an institution, legacy of the institution, IIT Guwahati must remember, IIT Guwahati must always remember that how we came into existence. It is not a normal delivery, it was a caesarean delivery at that point of time. So when we realize that how we came into existence, our responsibility to the state, to the people of Assam grows manifold. So as a normal institute, yes, we are located in some place. So we have a duty towards the society, towards the people. But when we come into existence, after a long struggle, and as a result of collective aspiration of the people, I think I owe much more to this land, to this society. So I'd like to remind all of you that yes, whenever you are on your journey, I am sure that this journey is very interesting. We have heard Director of IIT, Professor Borua, how this institute has achieved to a different level, both globally, internationally, nationally, and in the society of all other, compared to all other IITs. But I'd like to request you to keep that things in mind. And I'd like to request all of you, particularly the faculty members, to see that all our alumni who goes out of this state after their successful career, keep their life contact with this state. If we can give them a value, if we can provide them a value of a true Assamese, true Indian, when they studied in this campus, I think that live link will be always there. I want to hear that news, not what we have done globally. I want to hear that news that yes, that IIT alumni of IIT Guwahati has done this thing for the state of Assam. That things I want to hear. And I think if we continuously give them the spirit of being an Assamese, being an Indian, I think we'll have lot of positive outcomes or lot of contribution we'll get from our alumni and from this great institution. Director, IIT has already mentioned about the various partnership with the state of Assam, which IIT Guwahati is already doing. I'd like to flag certain points today so that we can deepen our partnership. We are already engaged in role of consulting, giving advice in government of Assam in various project formulation. I think that work we need to do continuously, but not in a mechanical mode or not in an outsourcing mode, but actually putting our mind and soul there, because this is a poor state. This is a state which want to aspire to be big. So if our projects, if our public money, if we cannot utilize 100% for the benefit of the society, Assam may not get that kind of money next time. For us, if we get today 1 rupee from the central government, we cannot generate that 1 rupee internally next time. That is the final amount, final fund which will come to this state. So if we can utilize that amount 100% for the benefit of the society will grow. So I'd like to request you that whenever you are entrusted with any consultancy work, give your heart and soul so that we achieve sustainability, we achieve durability, and we achieve the stated goal. So that will be one of the my requests. Second is our outreach program. That is very, very important, because if we can have a outreach program on various level with our universities, with our engineering colleges, with societies at large, I think we'll be immensely benefited. Technology, artificial intelligence is the future fulcrum of the growth. IIT needs to come closer with other Assam university in uplifting agriculture, information technology, prevent land erosion, ensuring sustainable growth through innovative technology. Just to name a few, I think there is no limit. We can keep on extending our outreach program, but outreach program, I think it will be very, very important for the institute and as well as for the society. Then again, we need to do serious research being the premier institute. We have just heard the chairman of Board of Governors, Sri Modi, who has laid emphasis that how this institution has acquired the premier role of research or premier role for guiding the society over the last 28 years. However, we are yet to find out certain solution to our nagging problems that has been faced by the society at large. Erosion of the Brahmaputra River is very, very important issue. We are still having floods in spite of putting money, lots of money on embankments. Sometime I have seen the frustration of policy makers. Whenever we go to the central government and we request for fund, they always said that how much we have to give you money for tackling the flood situation. So many people, even at Delhi, they think that whatever fund is coming for actually for managing floods in Assam is going on wastage. But that point of time, we request them that give us a technology so that you do not have to release money after money. Because we have the only technology which is available with us is constructing embankment. So what is that alternative? Why the country as a whole in last 75 years could not come with that alternative? So whether that question is to be answered by a politician or by bureaucrats or by the premier institution or academia or by the scientists. So I have on many occasions, I still remember, I participated some in national television debate during last, I think, floods 2 years before. One of the colleague from Assam who was earlier doing journalism in Assam, now he has shifted the base. He started saying that people are wasting money in embankment. I also agree, we are wasting money on embankment. But at least that is the only weapon available to us for short-term mitigation. Now, what is the alternative? That alternative, as a politician, I will not have that alternative. My role is to implement that alternative. So what is that alternative? Is the dredging is feasible? Or doing some other kind of things, what Brahmaputra Board did earlier, that is the solution? I don't know. But I think gradually, we need to have concentrated effort to see that the nagging problems which our society is facing. IIT Guwahati putting lot of minds and effort on that so that we can have some solution at some point of time. Evolving future vision is very important. We have talked about futuristic courses, future vision. I think that future vision should also, when it is, we go through a particular track that this will be the future of India, this will be the future of education, this will be the future of the society, this kind of courses we need to put it in institution. I think that knowledge need to be shared so that other institution also gets benefited. We have seen during the COVID-19 period, IIT Guwahati has helped us with lot of innovation. We work very closely with IIT Guwahati. Rather, at some point of time, we have utilized Ontario campus for managing COVID. But those are the days. We are really thankful for management of IIT Guwahati for helping government of Assam. But I think in long term, how we fight the pandemic, that is very, very important. We have seen that people are talking about first wave, people are talking about second wave, people are talking about third wave. It's really frustrating. So how we can do a better job, how we can manage, whether we need to live with COVID-19 or whether there is some alternative, or we'll have finally some solution which will be before us. I think we need to continuously put our effort on life science, on other frontier areas relating with the pandemic. I am sure that in next 10 years, more than artificial intelligence or information technology, the buzzwords will continue to be pandemic. So I think that things we have to remember, and we need to keep on our improve research work on managing, how to manage a pandemic and how we can be more competent to handle pandemic without losing our life. I already mentioned you that during the pandemic, IIT Guwahati has helped us a lot. IIT Guwahati, apart from providing various sophisticated instrument to National Health Mission, Assam, to carry out testing of COVID-19 pandemic, has developed, manufactured and commercialized COVID-19 related equipment and kits, such as disinfected drones, data-driven state-wise assessment of COVID-19, Fliji mobile application for safe and contactless air travel and others. I once again want to acknowledge and thanks Director of IIT, Professor T.G. Sitharaman, and the faculty members and staff for leading the institute in helping the state in fighting against the pandemic. Another short-term requirement or short-term request, that we have seen a society, if we do not teach our students about basic science, then society will not grow. Over the period, I have noticed that in Assam, the quality of education, particularly maths and science, has come down immensely. I think that is the area where short term our teaching community and IIT Guwahati can do a collaborative exercise, where we can encourage our teachers, we can create lot of young teaching pools who in turn can create an environment of teaching maths and science in our society. So that will be one of my requests, that IIT Guwahati can take up that project, and state government will definitely come out with all kind of help in that particular direction. I have been told that IIT Guwahati wants to start a medical school in the campus. I have already instructed my DC to provide additional land for that purpose, and if this project really comes up, it will be really good. And because, as I told you, that pandemic has really brought back the focus on the health sector, I think this is another area where we can work closely. Finally, we have seen that now, last 10 years, or basically we have seen post 2014, Assam is really on a growth path. Last 5 years, we have achieved GDP, better GDP than a national average. And our, in a way, the connectivity has improved tremendously. Now, northeastern region is closely connected with the mainland of India, never before. Thanks to the initiative of Prime Minister Modi, now this area itself enriched because we are going to have our new Shista Institute AIIMS soon in this year itself. So all this has brought back the focus on Northeast and Assam. The Act East policy, various projects taken under Act East policy are bringing back complete focus to the Northeastern region. I particularly see that once Act East policy is materialized and Assam can share its experience, its market with our neighboring state, I think a lot of actions will come back towards the Northeastern part of the country. So we must ready for that kind of role as a collectively as a society, and of course IIT Guwahati as a premier institute. So once again, I'd like to thanks all of you for exciting journey in last 28 years. I have seen in my own eyes how this institution has grown over the years. I recall the contribution of each and every one who has contributed for this growth of this institute. I am sure that under the leadership of present director, Professor T.G. Sitaram, this institute will further grow and fulfill the aspiration of our society. Once again, I'd like to congratulate all of you. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Bande Mataram.
माननीय मुख्यमंत्री महोदय को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद अपने बहुमूल्य विचार हमारे साथ साझा करने के लिए. थैंक यू सो मच सर. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वी विल नाउ प्रोसीड विद द रिलीज ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट आर्ट ऑफ एन इंस्टीट्यूशन रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ द कमिटी ऑन एडवांसिंग इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडिंग. मे आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट our honorable chief guest, honorable chief minister of Assam, to release the document art of an institution. Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor A. Chattopadhyay to please come up on stage and present two slide presentations on the art of an institution. Professor A. Chattopadhyay.
Okay, in between, let me speak. Because I am a teacher, when you give me 5 minutes, you are punishing me. I have to teach 55 minutes minimum per class to earn my salary. So 5 minutes means 1/11th of that time. So I will try to speed up. I will give you a little bit history. I will come in a moment within that time. When I arrived at this place, North Guwahati, on 30th November 1995. We had a picnic arranged by Gautam Barua and our first director, Professor Bura Gohai, who is also here. And I will tell you at that moment what was my observation. My observation was that everybody else was uncertain about the future of IIT Guwahati except for two people. You can know that who are the two people, Professor Bura Gohai and Gautam Barua. They are exactly determined what to be done at that point. And that is the reason we are here. Because this place at the time was only mud and hills, beautiful hills, obviously. No road, nothing. By 98, we started taking classes in the campus. And by 2003, we have academic complex and then onwards. So what is it? Determination. And both Professor Bura Gohai and Gautam Barua, since Chief Minister is here also, I should mention that, they demonstrated to the country and the world that in the most difficult place, at that time people used to say, most difficult time, you can establish an IIT and show that you can grow very fast. How fast? That time is scalable, depends on the society, people and all, but these two directors, one after another, demonstrated that you can grow as an IIT very fast. Their duties, they did for first 20 years. That's why we are here today. And I will tell you what, first four things they made sure we all had access to. Bijli, Sarak, Pani and Internet. From 95, I noticed that. And till now, that was the primary reason we have prospered very fast. Second is that we need, how to make an institution like Harvard, MIT, Stanford? Actually, nobody knows. No one in the world knows how to make. Many people try, very few people succeed. So we have, Professor Sitaram last year asked us to deliberate on this. He made the committee, he advised us what to be done, recommendation. So we deliver, 10 people deliberated, and we have made the recommendations. The 5 minutes is not enough, but I will give you the key points. First is, we need lots of money. With Harvard budgets in $1 billion, we cannot make with 50 crores per year budget. You cannot compete, as simple as that. If we had 1,000 crores of budget per year, we'll be within 100 at this inflation rate. But that's still a dream. We have to figure out. The most pertinent question throughout the world, throughout the time, is that if you are so smart, why aren't you rich? Smart people don't know how to become rich. Only some figure out. That's the problem of IIT also, how to become rich, also you have to figure it out. Some of our students figure it out. If we can earn lots of money, we will prosper, everybody will prosper. Society will prosper also. That is number one. Number two is that you need to collect large number of very smart people. I am very fortunate that I have been taught and met some of the really smartest people on the earth. And realize how they think, how they work, and respect the talent. I'll give an example. All of you know Shyamaprasad Mukherjee, the founder of Jansangh. His father was the Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University, who invited C.V. Raman to join the university. C.V. Raman put conditions that these are the conditions you must fulfill in order for me to join. What are the conditions? Salary, these, that. He was getting less salary than earlier. 250 rupees house allowance, no requirement of foreign visits, and all these. Vice Chancellor said, whatever you say, we will give you. He collected people from all over India, very talented people, and established, I read some of the correspondence, how he was trying to raise money. Because 100 years ago, because of civil disobedience movement, India was going through recession also at the time. So how he was trying to raise money just to hire Meghna Shah, who was studying in Germany. I was reading some of the correspondence. So money is number one, talented people, respect for the talented people. Talented people will normally disagree with you. That's the bottom line of progress, disagreement. So what is art? Art is that in an institution to grow up fast, administration, research community, and teaching community must come together and work very hard, focused, and achieve targeted goals in a very time-bound fashion. Nowhere in the world anybody can progress with the attitude of lahe lahe. Everybody has to move fast because the world is moving fast. I will not be there 100 years from now. I have to do during my lifetime. So these we have identified, I just scroll through it, that we have identified the parameters. I cannot describe to you. This is a more than 20-page document. You read through it. That administration is very important. Because if I go to an office and every day I get disenchanted that my file is not cleared, I would not be able to love the institute. I use this argument to all my administrative colleagues that total number of files in a year you have to clear is same. So why not clear earlier, not later? So that attitude, that service attitude has to come. IIT Guwahati, I will tell you, probably I've seen other IITs and institutions, is one of the very fortunate Indian institutes where very talented people are in administration. probably because this is the best job they can have in this region. Research is something creativity, it is expression of creativity. It's not that you can break somebody's head. Stalin tried, but he could not do that with physicists, that and ask for research. People have to try, give opportunity. Most of the time it will fail, but success may come. And the teaching, I think as an Indian community, we have a tradition of good teaching for maybe roughly 150 years. So that we can enhance. I was encouraged by the Prime Minister in 2014 statement that India wants to become teachers of the world. We'll be happy to see that, but for that we need focused approach. Without that we will not have. So these three components are there, you can read. We have made several recommendations, and many of them is that collaborate as fast as possible. With little money you have, collaborate. Chief Minister emphasized, Gautam Budha emphasized, the director emphasized, everybody emphasized, BOG chairman also. That is possible because most of our students are going abroad doing research during summer term. Why not collaborate during that time? Both of us will benefit at that time and outcome of it. And obviously, I will tell you, after we came, the whole of Guwahati academic atmosphere I saw change very fast. And that's because competition, that's the key to prosperity. Guwahati University, Cotton College, now Cotton College State Universities, other universities, they came up. At that time, 1995, I thought that why not Guwahati become the place for higher academic institutions only. It is almost there. We have a few industries here, small scale, and Chief Minister is here. We can have really, since the bridge is being built, we can have the academic town, like in the US, collaborate and prosper together. And academic institutions help benefit local more than any other organizations. So before I leave, since Gautam Budha is here, I must tell that one report. This is most personal, but still it is important how focused approach helped. In 2004, Gautam Budha established Center for Nanotechnology at IIT Guwahati with other two centers. Then our mandate was to do highest level of science as early as possible. So 2004 to 2014, we were doing that. He helped. Professor Sienna also helped in buying equipment. I'll tell you how easy it is when your director helps you very fast. We presented for a sophisticated instrument that costs 3.5 crores. So Sienna Rao was the chairman of the committee. He called me afterwards. He said, I don't have that much money. I can give you 2 crore only. You call Gautam now and tell me that he can give rest of the money or not. So I had, there was no mobile phone with me. So I used the outside landline and called him. He said, okay, you will say yes. That is how we started. By 2014, we had earned enough confidence of the nation such that a major project was funded. Initially, we emphasized, given the conditions, that publications and patents will be there, but by 2021, we were forced, we tried opening up incubation centers, companies, inventions, almost transferred to some technology have been transferred already. Market force, we don't have experience, we don't know whether we'll survive. Now we are aiming for industrial collaboration. Within a year, 2022, we'll be able to report to you how successful we are in industrial collaboration. We had last week a meeting, major meeting with three industries from Pune. So the research for the industries, for the products, will be done here only. In a town, I propose that let us start on 1st September 2021, but we'll start soon. So focused approach, by another 5 years, we should be able to have even better conditions. And institution support is always the key. Professor Sitaram continues to support all of us. We hope we will have a great time. So essentially, what do we need? Not only desires, but we must spend. I have estimated that 10% of the society people must work very hard for the improvement of the society. And I'll give you something to think. This is my personal opinion. I've been thinking why independent India did not prosper, seem to prosper in science and technology as much as dependent India, that is subjugated India under British. I have given myself the answer. This is debatable, but I'll still give you the answer for thought. Till 14th August or 13th August 1947, we are part of first world countries. From 15th August 1947, we became third world country. So it is our duty to move forward to second world, then first world, then we'll may, having Harvard, MIT in India. And Assam is a beautiful place for academics because the 8 months of the year, the weather is great. I'll request the Chief Minister to emphasize more academic institutions such that we can prosper together. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. May I now request the Dean of Public Relations, Branding and Ranking, Professor P.K. Iyer, to please present the vote of thanks.
So greetings to everyone present here. And those across the globe, of course, who are attending this meeting online. It is now my pleasant duty to propose a vote of thanks. So on behalf of the organizing committee, I express my sincere gratitude to the Honorable Chief Minister, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma ji, for sparing his very valuable time to grace this 28th Foundation Day celebrations of IIT Guwahati. Your words of wisdom today and advice on consultancy, outreach, collaboration in teaching, and sharing your vision for the higher educational institutes, enlightening us with the vision of Assam and the role of IIT Guwahati in development of our state and this region will lead to rapid development across various sectors that you mentioned. Thank you very much, sir. We look forward to work with you very closely, and hopefully our faculties and students along with the alumni that we have will contribute to all the points that you mentioned. Next, I would also like to mention that Professor Gautam Barua, who has taken out time to be present here, it's a great opportunity for us to still interact with you, and we keep learning from you, from your kind words and your advices. Thank you very much, sir, for being here. Further, I also express my thanks to all the dignitaries, various directors and vice chancellors who have been online, the honorable members of the Board of Governors of IIT Guwahati, the secretaries from the various central and the state ministry, officials from the government of Assam, definitely the security officials who have been doing a great job since yesterday, the distinguished guests for being with us. Please pardon me if I missed out on calling out or reading out the names of any guests. However, I heartily thank you all for joining us in this event. I also take this opportunity to express my gratitude and thanks to all my colleagues at IIT Guwahati, beginning with our director, Professor T.G. Sitaram, who has been leading from the front in every aspect of development of the institute. Sir, we are very sure that your vision and enthusiasm will help IIT Guwahati prosper even further. I also thank our chairman, our BOG chairman, Dr. Rajiv I. Modi, for his support, encouragement, and his guidance to take IIT Guwahati to the next level. I would also like to thank our Deputy Director, Professor Kakuti, our Registrar, Professor A. Srinivasan, my colleagues across the Institute who have put in a lot of efforts to organize this event. While organizing an event of this magnitude, especially offline, after such a huge gap of this pandemic, were definitely a very difficult task. Yet, the dedicated efforts of everyone, the staff, even the people who are not directly associated with IIT Guwahati, who are part-time laborers or part-time workers, they all have put in a lot of effort. And it is really heartening to see that despite all the difficulties, people were working almost deep into the night, early morning, you know, this event has been successful. So once again, I am thankful to all of you who are not present right now in the hall, they are waiting out or they are watching online. Thank you very much for your kind support and my sincere appreciations and gratitude to you all. The institute has been growing consistently and its success is due to the immense contributions from everyone involved in its activities, and hence, on behalf of the organizing team, I express my sincere thanks to the faculty members, staff members, officers, students, distinguished alumni, and all stakeholders for their invaluable contributions over the past 27 years. And we truly look forward to your continuous support. The COVID-19 pandemic has definitely taught us very tough lessons and the hard way of life. The importance of moving forward despite this hardship, the emergence of the online meetings, the webinars, has allowed us to make this 28th Foundation Day event of IIT Guwahati an international one. As director mentioned, now it has been streamlined live on YouTube, Facebook, and the webcast. And I really thank the CET team, they're sitting right in the front, for their effort and all this thing to happen. Thank you very much. Last but not the least, I thank the entire students community who have been enduring all the difficulties through this pandemic. There are a lot of students sitting here in this corner. So thank you very much for even joining us here. And there are all these difficulties, and despite all these difficulties, I'm sure that you all have been very patient and enthusiastically looking forward to return back to campus. And I assure you on behalf of the institute that we are trying very hard to get you all back to campus. I take this opportunity once again to sincerely thank everyone for being part of this 28th Foundation Day event of IIT Guwahati. Stay safe and healthy. Thank you very much and Jai Hind.
देवियों और सज्जनों, इसी के साथ संस्थान के 28वें स्थापना दिवस के कार्यक्रम को हम यहीं समाप्त करते हैं. वी थैंक एवरीवन प्रेजेंट फॉर बीइंग हियर विद अस, एंड वी आल्सो थैंक एवरीवन हु आर वाचिंग दिस प्रोग्राम ऑनलाइन. वी विश यू अ वेरी नाइस डे अहेड. थैंक यू. नमस्कार.